your friends behind. Cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go where we want to, place where they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world, leave the real one far behind.
Safety Week 2001, safety clip, and action. I said action. Just get started already, come on.
Night is young and so am I. And we can dress real neat from our hearts to our feet and surprise them with a victory cry.
Hi everybody, welcome to Safety Week 2011. Working in the hand tool shop allows you to be a lot more lax about certain safety operations. I did need hearing protection for that cut. Probably could have benefited from having a respirator on because the dust does get up in the air as it's carried up in the air by the saw, but it's bigger dust and it's not the stuff that's really, really harmful for you. Long exposure to it could possibly give you kind of a stuffy nose, things like that, but I can kind of forgo a lot of those things. Eye protection is really not necessary in that instance. And I think safety in the hand tool shop becomes even more important in the long run because we don't think about these things. The biggest thing that I run into in the hand tool shop is I'm not making dust, but as you look around, I'm mid-project here, and I have shavings and chips and things all over the floor. These anti-fatigue mats are usually pretty good about keeping kind of a grippy surface, but on this vinyl flooring I have here, the shavings particularly can be very slippery. The dust beneath your saw bench can become very slippery very fast. If you find yourself planing at the bench and standing only on shavings, a lot of times you'll find yourself slipping as you're planing. Anytime you slip, you lose control of things and you could very easily fall into a chisel lying on the bench. You could even catch yourself and cut yourself on your hand plane itself. These may seem like minor issues, but frankly, nobody wants to get hurt ever. Even slipping and falling could end up knocking your head on the bench. Or, you know, something as minor as pulling a hamstring. Now granted, that's a pain and you're going to be laid up for a while. It's certainly not life-threatening, but it's something that you have to be aware of. As you're working through a project, it's always a good idea to come around and vacuum up some of the chips, sweep up some of the chips to prevent things from getting too slippery. For that matter, having a huge buildup of chips on the floor, especially if you're working all with one species, if you drop a piece that maybe, you know, a small piece that you actually need, it becomes really difficult to find sifting around through the chips and things on the floor. Chips, shavings, and things like that on the bench, I believe I've talked about this before, but all manner of things can be hiding underneath these ingrained shavings of my shooting board here. I have a chisel lying right next to it, but what if that chisel will run underneath those shavings? And I go to move the chisel off the, or move the shavings off the bench, and I hit my hand with it. It's one of the reasons I always recommend using a brush to sweep things off your bench. However, I could end up sweeping my chisel right off the bench onto the floor or onto my foot. And it's just something that you need to be aware of. A clean space is going to be a safe space. Hand tool woodworking, while it may not produce a lot of airborne dust, it produces a lot of large bodied waste like chips and shavings that can build up very, very quickly and can be a safety hazard very fast. So keep your workspace clean, try to keep your benchtop clean. You'll end up having a much safer and more enjoyable experience.